Now that I have set up my brushes in Photoshop, I've got my preferences set up, I've got my workspace ready to go, now it's time to colorize some line art. So I'm going to show you in this video the first simplest technique, which is just applying flat color. So I'm going to go to File and Open. Here on my desktop, I will go to my Chapter 2 folder and right there, colorize parts of this line art. So the first thing you're going to notice is you have a flat background layer. Now that's the first problem. You cannot colorize line art properly in Photoshop if you're working on a flat background layer. We need to treat this line art like an animation cell, the traditional coloring process of animation. So the first thing you do is double click the background layer and rename that line art. That's what's on that layer, so that's what I'm going to call it. Okay. The second thing is you have to treat this the way it appears. This is black ink printed on a white sheet of paper. Traditional animation cells are not printed on white paper. They're printed on a cell. They're printed on like transparency surfaces or a sheet of glass, if you want to envision it that way. So when a layer is set to a blending mode of normal, all the colors are solid. This is black ink printed on solid white. But just like traditional animation cells, you paint underneath on the back side of the glass, on the back side of the cell. Okay, you can't paint on the back side of paper. You're not going to see it. So just to prove that, I'm going to create a brand new blank layer by clicking on this little plus. And then I'm going to go to my brush. I'm going to come out onto my file. I can't do it out here. I'll come onto my file, hold Control key and Option key on my Mac. That would be Control key and Alt key on your PC. On a Mac, you hold those two keys down and press on the mouse. On a PC, you hold Control, Alt, and use your right side mouse button to increase or decrease the size of your brush. Now, in order to pick a color, you have two different options. You can go right up here to your color panel, and you've got your values and your visible spectrum, but that's kind of small. So right over here, this is black is my foreground color. You can see it by hitting the letter D for default colors. And when I click on black, I get a larger preview screen than this tiny color panel. Okay, so let's say I want to paint with red. I scroll up to the red values, then I jump in here and I pick which shade of red that I want to paint with. From the brightest, which is white in the upper left corner, to the purest, which is in the upper right. And as I go down, those colors get darker and darker. But I'm going to go way up here. When I click OK, now I'm ready to paint with red. I always paint on a separate layer. That way I can change my mind later. And here's the problem. I'm just going to paint a big X right there. And obviously, you don't want to paint above your line art because you are covering your artwork. But if I pull the layer under the line art, that's like tucking artwork under a sheet of white paper. You're not going to see it. So let's throw that away right down here to the little trash. And then the second thing you want to do for your line art is change the layer's blending mode. How is this line art going to blend in with the red that I painted? Okay, right up here, when it says normal, that's normal black ink on normal white paper. I want Photoshop to think of all the white areas as glass, invisible areas, transparent areas. So you set the layer's blending mode to multiply. Humans will still see the white. Photoshop does not see white anymore. It's like invisible to Photoshop, okay? Trust me. Now, the next thing you don't want to do is accidentally paint on your line art layer because that ruins the line art. So I'll go to Edit and undo that, obviously. And I'm going to protect this layer. I called it line art because that's what's on the layer. I multiplied the blending mode so I can see through the white areas. And then right underneath multiply, it says lock. All the way to the right is a big white lock. So I'm going to click that and protect this layer. I can no longer paint anything on this layer. Okay, the only thing that should ever be there is line art. So what I'm going to do is select an area. Let's say we want to paint the sun. So I'm going to take my zoom tool. I can click and drag to the right to zoom in. Click and drag to the left to zoom out. And if it lands kind of off center like that, you go zoom in and out and you want it to be over here. You can hold your space bar for your hand tool and just kind of move it around on your screen. But I want to zoom in again. And what you have to keep in mind is that you are not actually looking at a drawing. You're looking at a mosaic. See, we don't really actually see a curved line right here. We see picture elements. A mosaic. Every single square is a pixel and they can be different values. So when you zoom in close, you can see the black line art and the white area, but you also have these gray pixels right along the edge. Those help your eye to blend transitional values. Those are called anti-alias pixels. They allow us to kind of trick our brain and think we are looking at a nice smooth curve. If those little gray pixels weren't there, we would see something that looks like a 1980s Super Nintendo Mario Brothers game. It would be very choppy. It's also called a bitmap. But we want those smooth curves. Okay, so what I'm going to do is now that my line art is protected, I go to the second tool down on the right. When I press and hold, I want the magic wand tool. Your magic wand is for selecting blank areas of color, flat areas of color. So if I'm on the line art layer and I click, I have selected this big white space indicated by these little marching ants called a selection marquee. Okay, but there's more than just this part of the sun. There's the rays. So in order to select more than one area, you simply hold your shift key and you will see a plus next to your magic wand. So I can shift click, 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 and shift click. Now, here's the issue. I want you to remember that anytime you use the magic wand, it is good. It is not perfect. Okay? When I zoom in right here, you can see that your selection goes right to the edge of these gray pixels. Okay? There's little gray pixels along these edges. You can see a whole bunch of them up here, which means if I were to fill this area gold, you would see gold, a thin, ugly gray outline of pixels, and then your black line art. All your color would be surrounded by a thin gray edge, and that looks bad. So we want to counteract that gray by jumping past the grays. Your magic wand won't do that. Your magic wand is good, it is not perfect. So when you are done selecting areas, when you are totally done with the magic wand, each and every time, you have to go to select menu, since you're dealing with a selection, modify your selection to make it better, and you will expand your selection by one pixel. Jump past that one gray pixel along those edges. So when you click OK, you've bypassed those gray pixels. Perfect. I'm going to click and drag to the left with my zoom tool to zoom back out. Hold my space bar for the hand and move it over. And then in the next video, because I don't want these to drag on too long, I'm going to show you how we apply color fills in the simplest manner by just using flat color. But you gotta understand how to use your magic wand in order to make your good selections so you can fill them properly as well. I'll see you in a few minutes in the next video.